This is theatre. It's 15th century performance. And what's incredible about this piece of glass is that, you know, as a maker, I'm looking at it and I'm trying to think my way into this incredible series of movements that are here. You've got coiling, you've got dripping, you've got this incredible, powerful kind of transitive pushing and kind of thrusting of the great kind of sticky gobstopper blues and reds actually into the glass. And then you've got these great pinchings are all the way around here as well. So everything has a different kind of movement, all held together into this one extraordinary kind of object. But it's for use. I mean, that's the next incredible thing about this object. It's an object to actually go round the table. It's a welcoming cup. You have to imagine this filled with wine. So imagine this turning red, this becoming a red object, holding red light. And the other thing which is miraculous about this, of course, is that it's from Venice. Venice is the threshold. It's between all kinds of Orient and the West. So into Venice come all the merchants. There's gold from Africa, which is part of this. Some of the materials come from South Asia. And into this sort of melting pot of Venice, of course, come stories. You know, this is the city of Marco Polo, for goodness sake. And out of Venice come objects and stories of unparalleled richness and strangeness. It's an object for the Kunstkammer, for the Wunderkammer, for these spaces which are just filled with treasures. And they're filled in very specific ways. These aren't sort of random objects that are just sort of, that congregate by chance in people's collections. They're an extraordinary way of mapping the world. This is Venetian showing off. They do it very well.